We're gonna take you to Nagaland. You know why? You know why? Because while we were like, how do I put it? We were kind of, the girls are beautiful. That's what I want to say.
Yeah, you know, Isaac.
Everything is beautiful. So we thought, as promised last week, we're gonna check out the part two. This is not requested by anybody, but the thumbnail shows that the YouTube Tanya wearing the wig, kind of like a cosplay. I want to see that.
That's interesting.
That's the only reason why we're doing this. Check it out.
What's cooking today?
The modern Naga lifestyle.
You can see for yourself.
Yeah, he'll cook live for us.
Absolutely.
Wow.
I think if you're lucky, Santila Yahar will be coming.
This is how the fashion started from Hong Kong market.
So I don't have this. This one is me and then one is me.
Aur ab, aage. तो आपने नागालैंड के बारे में क्या सुना है? यहाँ के सुंदर नज़ारे, खाना, what's cooking today? शायद लोगों के बारे में सुना होगा, फैशन के बारे में तो नहीं सुना होगा, है ना?
Very nice.
And this market is so dynamic. है मेरा नाम है तानिया and I am on a mission to discover more about नागालैंड. और इस सफर में मेरा साथ देंगे मेरे कुछ दोस्त. तो फिर हमारे साथ आइएगा जरूर फॉर तानिया खनिजो प्रेजेंट्स टेक मी टू नागालैंड.
What is this part to focusing on? The modern Naga lifestyle.
जितना भी थक जाओ, अच्छे खाने से सब ठीक हो जाता है. और अच्छे खाने के साथ अगर इंस्पायरिंग लोग भी हो, तो और मजा आ जाता है. जैसे आज लॉन्गचेन होमस्टे में हमारे साथ हैं दो बहुत ही खास लोग.
हेलो हाय, I'm Chef Imna here.
So Chef Imna is a chef at the famous restaurant Modern April in Dimapur and is also a member of the Slow Food Community Nagaland for Biodiversity and Heritage Preservation, which is doing some amazing work in the field of safeguarding and promoting the indigenous traditional agri-food culture of Nagaland. The convivium leader of the community is Chef Joel Basumatari.
I'm Santila Yangar, a textile specialist. Anything to do with culture and heritage is
her
forte.
She was also awarded Padma Shri in 2008 for her work towards empowering local women through handicrafts. Mrs. Santila has the reputation here of being a very, very learned and educated lady, and she knows all about Naga culture and history and food also, which is why we have this lavish spread over here. So what are the ingredients over here, if you can go over them?
This is the fresh bamboo shoot, fermented bamboo shoot.
You know, I can smell the bamboo shoot over here.
Bamboo shoot.
It's a very strong fermented smell. But this is, I think, the main flavoring ingredient.
Papa Sundar,
Rambo. In most of the cuisine. This is
you
another
have,
one.
This is also fermented.
Okay.
But as you can see, this is already a crushed paste, shredded.
Here we came to know about the ingredients that go into the food, like mitchinga leaves, chiswan peppercorn, baby aubergine, king chili, chow chow or scotch, ground red chili, local spring onion, dried yam leaves, garlic, cherry tomatoes, etc. Me and Larissa. Okay.
Good luck.
Hey, they eat chili.
Raw.
Oh, it has an after khatta taste. For dinner, we tried the au cuisine and the au rice. So here we had some boiled vegetables, chicken cooked with bamboo shoot, local spring onion and king chili.
Chicken with bamboo shoot.
And rice.
And what was the black box?
Yam.
Okay.
Yam do pa ya?
Leave it for like 5 minutes. Take it out, pound it.
Okay.
And cook it.
Yeah. While you taste the pork, I'm going to taste some of this vegetable.
Oh, pork with yam.
This is very good. Bamboo shoot flavor. So, अब आप ये सोच रहे होंगे कि खाना तो ठीक है.
So in the Naga kitchen, you'll always find baskets over here.
पर क्या ये एपिसोड फैशन के बारे में नहीं है? तो सच तो ये है कि अगले कुछ 15 मिनट में हम हिस्ट्री, फूड, मार्केट्स और ऐसे ही कुछ गहराइयों में जाके देखेंगे कि इन चीज़ों से यहाँ के लोगों का लाइफस्टाइल कैसे बदला है. एंड द नेक्स्ट थिंग ऑन द एजेंडा इज गोइंग टू द कैपिटल सिटी ऑफ कोहिमा फ्रॉम दीमापुर. And over here we are staying at D Oriental. ये एक बहुत ही famous hotel है इस जगह का. बहुत ही अच्छी location है. Rooms are excellent. We just checked in a while back. And today we are headed to the market of Nagaland. सबसे पहले हम देखेंगे कि इस शहर को शहर बनाने वाले लोग कौन हैं. यहाँ के लोग क्या खाते हैं और shopping कहाँ से करते हैं. So everybody, meet our local friends in Kohima. That is Nicholas. I've actually met him before in Zero. That is George. He is also going to be helping us locally.
Exactly.
That is Max. Oh, and Nicholas got us these fruits. Peach.
Good stuff.
Very good stuff. Thank you, Nicholas.
Hey,
yeah, we're waiting
for
sound
here.
Okay.
Yes.
Hi, Kiko. How are you?
Olivia.
Hi, Olivia. I love your earring.
Thank you. So, first of all, we went to the bamboo market, which has a revolutionary bamboo architecture, to see some of the locally grown vegetables.
Ready for pakoras, also making pakoras.
Oh, this is for making pakoras.
Yeah. Some of them a little too exotic for us.
What else have we got here?
Bamboo shoot.
Oh,
so many bamboo shoots.
Wow. I think it's a common food in
Kuto. And you can get only in that season.
So this is vegetable.
Yeah,
Kuto.
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 Kuto. Kuto.
Never seen that before.
Kuto. Kuto. Kuto means bird.
Back.
Okay.
Oh my!
From here we went to Mao Market. The tribes of Nagaland have a long history of people relying on nature and natural products, and also the fullest utilization and consumption of naturally occurring food products like bee larvae, which are very nutritious, by the way. Woodworms is a very expensive delicacy.
Expensive, no? Oh, this is expensive stuff,
I'm
man.
I'm not going to eat, I will sell it.
Here in Nagaland, we have woodworms. And these woodworms actually cost 2,200 rupees, these many woodworms.
Exactly.
They're very difficult to come by, George.
Yeah.
Which is why they're expensive.
Yes, yes. And it's in high demand. People really like it.
Mm. They're crawling down my arm. And lastly, we experienced the Naga coffee at Cafe Ethics.
Oh, bisa lah.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, and she's been like holding a gimbal throughout. We had to introduce Namrata on camera, so abhi main thodi der piche khadi hungi and Namrita hume coffee ke bare mein.
Oh, she's the cameraman, eh?
Aur chai bhi nahi peeti. Which coffee do you want, Narsa?
Oh, by the way, क्योंकि नागालैंड एक dry state है, यहाँ के major hangout spots जो होते हैं youngsters के लिए वो coffee shops and cafes होते हैं. And interestingly, coffee was started growing in Nagaland just 5 years ago in the mountainous region. And now a large percentage of coffee beans are exported to South Africa. So the coffee which is grown here in relatively high altitude Himalayan regions also has a very different taste. Definitely on the milder side, it's not very strong coffee. But I'm really liking it. Okay, so guess who did we have the good opportunity of meeting in Kohima? Meet the beautiful Lingzu and Kuku, who are the founders of Naga Street Style page on Instagram. They curate a lot of things about fashion and post it on that page, and it's quite famous on Instagram. You should go check it out.
We're so happy to have, you know, such beautiful YouTubers here. Yay. And yeah, we'd like to show you some things. We hope we can, you know.
And we are going thrift shopping today, so
yeah.
We're excited about
yeah,
that.
So these girls are taking us thrift shopping to some really unusual places that nobody has ever seen on YouTube before. So are you excited about that, Larissa?
I'm so excited. Excited to shop, in fact.
Me too.
There is the next one. Okay. So this is the market, okay? This is where it starts.
Okay.
So this whole thing is changed.
What is this market called?
BOC.
And where does this stuff come from in the, inside this market?
The Hindu order like a guinea.
From Korea.
Market jual baju-baju, pasar.
Interesting.
No, this is not it. This is like more like
these are from
traditional market condition.
Okay, guys.
But the stuff is fashionable stuff.
Bandung.
Pasar
Jakarta,
I guess.
Cookie is Larissa's nickname. They are going to be one team, and me and Lingzu So we are going to pick up two outfits each in two different categories. One is going to be vintage outfit, and one is going to be a Japanese looking outfit, Japanese slash Korean, like Asian influence kind of an outfit. So since this market specializes in these categories of clothes, they are going to help both of us, and we are going to come up with an outfit, and then you guys get to decide who wins.
Okay.
What do you think is Asian inspired exactly?
Like Koreans, even manga.
Yeah.
We're very inspired by leisure these days, right?
Yeah,
now,
I see. It's very, Korean,
And
also, I
see that picture, I wouldn't even realize if they're from Nagaland. They might be there from Korea, you know?
Asian inspired, because I've seen a lot of Japanese people wearing long coats. Koreans wearing long coats, yes. So I think this is also one cue we have.
We're looking for vintage looking clothes. You wouldn't find like vintage outfits here, but there are a lot of vintage looking items. So we're looking around.
She's holding so many cameras.
Found something interesting.
I didn't realize that.
Something for the two looks from the market. Like for the first look, I got a frilly collar with a polka dot.
Frilly to lecak kan?
Oh yeah, loose. Lemas gitu bahannya.
Oh, tapi kayak lecak gitu tadi. Atau apa belum?
Semua di situ.
The outfit to complete look one.
Oh, itu bukan karena emang gayanya kayak gitu ya, atau emang belum
dari bahannya, emang dijualnya begitu.
Oh, emang belum digosok lah ya.
Belum digosok, karena ini kan thrift shop ya, dia bilang.
This a beautiful red one as well.
Bisa ya pakai beli dari itu jadi kayak fashionable gitu.
While we enjoyed our trip with fashion, it was also a reminder of how the beautiful city of Kohima is at once at the cusp of modernity and development, and also a lack of it.
She's holding so many cameras.
Yeah.
The advocate of best fashion talks about the lack of good tailored suits in the market of Kohima. Everything is not really readily available here. That's because the history of the city is also relatively not that old. The city was actually formed in the year 1878 when the British Empire established its headquarters in the Naga Hills, but it was only after 1944 and the Battle of Kohima between the Allied forces and the Japanese that gave the formation of Kohima as we know of it today with increasing amounts of settlement. The epicenter of the city is Kohima War Cemetery that at once serves as a reminder of war and death, but also is a story of how Kohima came into existence.
Thousands and thousands of soldiers from both from Indian side, the Allied forces and Japanese, they died. It's a sad thing actually. But that has created history for us. You know, because of the war, the township came up, the Nagas, especially the tribals, became
united,
and also we came to know about things happening
outside
and
of Nagas.
And welcome people from outside also.
Yeah.
And this, sad part of the story, but also a joyful part of the story. Like
yes,
this place has contributed.
Yeah, so every dark cloud has a silver lining.
There is sunshine after every rain.
Yes.
So, Indians and from
British,
all over the world, yeah, British
also,
and even the Japanese.
Even the Japanese are buried here. Yeah. Okay.
But now we consider them as our friends.
It's called the famous tennis court where the British played tennis exactly in this place.
Oh.
That's why they have not even changed an inch of the location.
The location.
Yeah. So after the war only they have installed this cross as a sign of hope. Not really to symbolize the Christianity, but as a sign of hope and
sign
peace.
Sign of hope and peace. The city is new because the seat of modern administration was only set up here in 1968 when Nagaland officially became a full-fledged state and Kohima was declared capital. So while it may lack some modern amenities, it still has a newness to it. The beat, the rhythm, the mix of people, like this magnificent church that sits on the hills of the city. A gift of solidarity from the Japanese, a memorial for the soldiers who lost their lives in the Battle of Kohima, and a facade which stands out in the rush of the city.
So, abhi hum log hain Mary Help of Christian Cathedral mein, and Larissa.
Where is the part she's wearing a cosplay? Am I seeing it wrong in the thumbnail?
Huh?
Where is the part?
Oh yeah,
her?
The weekend.
So, really enjoy coming to.
Have I been tricked?
Wow, nice church.
Mm-hmm.
Very beautiful. Look at that glass mirror effect.
kayak gereja Batu. Atau gereja Manado, kayak gini.
Now an important site of worship for the Naga people who are predominantly Christian. Interestingly, Christianity also brought about many changes in the state. Just to give you a very small example, in terms of fashion and lifestyle, Christianity also brought Western fashion to the state, as explained by Mrs. Chanchala Younger in her interview to Motherland Magazine. Now, of course, I could go on and on about the fashion influences and
the thrift and about thrift ensemble.
We are still missing one important piece of the puzzle: the anime culture.
Ah, this one.
Okay, need to put on. And of course, ended up having a great evening with the cosplayers on our last night in Kohima. So in the end,
there's just something I'll leave with you to think about.
Yeah. Oh yeah, I just got bored of
my orange
hair, so now I have pink hair, and I think I can totally get used to this.
Do you think people are often misunderstood when we don't know them enough?
Yes, of course. What was your favorite part?
My favorite part is the food. The food, and then the cosplayer, the week. The pink wig that wear by siapa? Tanya ya. The
Which
wear
one?
By Tanya.
Tanya ya. Yeah. The other one is Larissa.
Yeah.
Hey. Anyway, my favorite part was definitely the cosplay part. Why?
Oh,
let me tell you why. All people who love anime are all good people.
That's some cliche sentence.
Doesn't matter where you're from. Whether you're from the Northeast, whether you are the South Indian, North Indian, Indonesian, Chinese. When you cosplay, it's all for good purpose. That was a very beautiful video. I thought we definitely learned more, at least this time, about Nagaland. I mean, really interested though in the thrift shop, because like, there's not a lot of thrift shop here in Jakarta. Maybe in Bandung.
Outside Jakarta, in
Bandung. Anyway guys, thank you for watching.
Thank you for watching.
See you guys later.
See ya.
Bye.